Vanderbilt at Missouri. Huh. Missouri is a 14-point favorite here at home, and this is a strange, strange situation here. It's 4 p.m. Eastern time on the SEC Network. We've seen Missouri do some pretty awesome things, right? This team looks really, really good. You know, let's go on through the trends. I'll go on and pull up the stats on the page here. The home team is 5-2 against the spread in the last 7 in this series. Now, Missouri, obviously the home team. That helps. Vanderbilt, however, 10-4 against the spread in their last 14 road games. Missouri is 6-1 against the spread in their last 7 SEC games. And Missouri is 8-3 against the number in their last 11 games overall. So this is a spot where you could certainly see yourself going with Missouri. Oh, they've got more talent, and oh, they this and that, da-da-da-da-da. Both of them have played super, super tough strength of schedules. Vanderbilt played Alabama and Georgia and Ole Miss. Missouri has played Georgia and Kansas State. You look at those numbers, and it ain't good, right? Green is good on my page. Red is bad. You start diving into what's going on here, and I'm sure you see right there in the middle of the page, I've got Vanderbilt actually favored in this game. I mean, we're talking like 19 points of value. Typically, I see something like that, and I go, you know what? Something's weird. We need to work with the formulas. We need to see what's going on. But that's happened multiple times this year, and it turned out my numbers were right. So there's a lot of people that are on Missouri right now. You start pulling up some of the actual numbers as far as people betting, and there's not a lot of people betting on Vanderbilt. They all think, oh, this is a short number, etc. Look, I think that Missouri's offense is bad enough that Vanderbilt will be able to hang around in this game. Missouri is number 106 in giveaways per game. Vandy is number 22. Vandy doesn't turn the football over. Missouri does. That's certainly something that could play in. Penalties per game. Missouri number 104. Vanderbilt number 19. Again, leans towards Clark Lee's bunch. Eli Drinkwitz is a great, great football coach as far as his mind goes. But Missouri does not have an overwhelming talent advantage over Vanderbilt right now. They just don't. The Missouri defense is really, really good, right? And the pass is what Vanderbilt really likes to do. They don't do it as much as they run, but A.J. Swan is pretty fantastic throwing the football. They're number 58 in PPA per pass, but you see all this green on the side here for Missouri, number 23 PPA per pass defense, number 38 pass rate, number 20 passing success rate allowed. They're number 11 in havoc rate on defense. They are number 11 in passing downs, PPA, etc. I still think, as bad as their offense is, their offense is not able to take advantage of Vanderbilt's defense the way that some of the better teams on the schedule have. I think Vanderbilt keeps it within the 14. I don't know that they win the game outright. Obviously, this is a 14-point underdog. That would be absurd. But my numbers like Vandy a lot. So go ahead and give me the Commodores. Give me the fighting Barton Simmons here. I like Vandy plus the 14 to cover against Missouri. I just think the number's wrong. I think a lot of people looking at this thinking, yeah, Missouri's way, way better. Like, and maybe they are, right? These are obviously the games that I did not like as much to give out as an official play. But we'll see. We will see with that.